Energy expert Dr. Muntaka Lolo, who is also the executive director at the Institute of Energy and Climate Change Policy, has called for a total overhaul of the country's energy sector. In a Skype interview with journalist Francis Aban on the Pulse, Dr. Muntaka explained that the overhaul will enhance private participation in both generation and distribution with less government interference, except for the purposes of straight. Now, he's convinced giving out ECG without complete sector reforms would lead to inefficient private sector management.
Institute of Energy and Climate Change Policy is calling for a complete sector reform of the energy sector to engage the private sector involvement in because we believe that government is on a move to give ECG out on a concession for 25 years, which we think is a good idea. But giving out just ECG without a complete sector reform might lead to inefficient privatization of the sector. Because the problem with our energy sector is not just with only ECG. It's kind of like it's a complete situation on its own. Not ECG is just one aspect of it. We have the generation aspect. We have the distribution aspect, we have the transportation aspect, and ECG is just one aspect.
When you say overhaul, what exactly should happen in each sector from generation to distribution?
Yeah, from generation to distribution, private involvement should be encouraged, and there should be the needed policies that will enhance private sector involvement, because all these agencies, ECG, Ghana Gas, VRA, they are all government-owned. And if you look at the analysis, they owe each other across board. And that is where the inefficiencies is coming from. If one sector is not able to pay its debts to the other sector, there is a problem. They cannot get, if VRA is not able to pay GMPC, that's Ghana Gas. Ghana Gas will not be able to produce, to supply VRA gas. And VRA wouldn't be able to produce electricity to supply to ECG. So if you privatize only ECG, leaving the other sectors, it's just like you are putting short-term solutions to problems.
But there are some who say, look, with all you talk about with the overhaul, all I'm hearing is privatization. But in the past, we've seen these bodies perform creditably without any private hands. Is it about us changing the way we do things with these companies rather than just opting to say, let's give it to the private man, he's profit-oriented, he can fix all our problems for us in one day?
Not necessarily just giving it to the private hands. We are not calling for just giving everything to the private hands without government control. Obviously, government has to control the sector. It has to be regulated. But this problem didn't just come up today. It's been on for so many years now. Subsequent governments always come, will solve the power situation, and it's been on and on and on and on. They implement policies that are, that are politically motivated and are not necessarily the right policies to reform the sector. So we believe that government should stay as a regulator and engage the private sector to manage those sectors, which could lead to efficiency and increased productivity. Because it's been handled by government for so many years now, and every day we come back to the same problem.
Is that to say that for ECG, that now a concessionaire is being sought for them to step in and fix, that in your view is the right way to go?
Management is supposed to plug the leakages, and management is ECG. And this is government control. And you see, government sometimes, are kind of reluctant, or not all government entities are really doing quite well as compared to the private sector. And private sector who is profit motivated, comes in with his investment with a aim that he has to recover his investment at a specific time. And he will put in all the necessary measures to plug in all the linkages, which is why we think the government agreement to give ECG out is a good one, but the manner in which they are doing it, we have a problem with that, because we think 25 years, it shouldn't be the case. It should be given out completely to different private actors, okay, but with strict regulation.
And that was the executive director for the Institute of Energy and Climate Change Policy, Dr. Muntaka Alolo, in an interview there with Francis Aban on The Pulse. Now, found in the Bunafu region in the Kentampo South District is Apesika. The roads there are made of mud, pools of water, potholes, and gullies. Inhabitants of Apesika are displeased at authorities for their failure to fix the road. Now, they are therefore threatening to boycott this year's elections. This is a citizen journalist report by Nanaya Edusipokwa from Star Ghana.
Apesika is a farming community in the Brahafo region. The name of the town translated from Akan means love for money. However, residents here are not dying for money, they are crying for good roads.
This is the road from Pentampo to Apesika. The road is very poor. It's no good at all. The farmers don't know even how to bring their foodstuffs from Apesika to Kentampo South or Kentampo for marketing. So this is Apesika Road. When it rains, you can imagine how it is.
The terrible state of the road has compelled Steven to use a donkey cart. Here, it is about the survival of the fittest. Pedestrians compete with motorbikes and cars for space. Lydia Amua, who speaks for the Queen Mother of Apesika, says residents here considering boycotting this year's general elections.
Anytime it rains, the road becomes unmotorable. We are forced to get down and push our cars on our way to Kentampo. So we are pleading to the authorities to come to our aid, else we will boycott the elections. Politicians keep reneging on their promise to fix the road after elections.
Mapa, another resident, says politicians have promised to fix the roads on countless occasions.
We do not see the relevance of election. Our roads are substandard. The elections are totally needless. Our roads are bad. We also do not have a secondary school. We need one here, and the next town is far. We should fix the road.
Latifa lost her sister due to the bad roads.
She complained of headache, and we gave her some medication. On our way to the hospital at Kintampo, it started raining cat and dogs till the next morning. We had no choice but to go back home without visiting the health facility because the road had been swallowed up by flood. She died because of the bad state of the roads. But for the road, she would have still been alive. The condition of the road can aggravate the already ailing condition of residents. When they use the Apesika Road, you will feel the pain all over our body when we use that road.
The unit committee chairman believes a boycott of the elections will be the wake-up call for politicians to attend to the needs of the people.
Pregnant women are suffering from spontaneous deliveries on this road. We do not have clinics too. If they do not come and fix the road, they should not come here on election day.
A poverty and politics report by citizen journalist Nanaya Edusi Pokia Apesika with support from Star Ghana.
Indeed, the residents seem a bit agitated by that, and you can't blame them. I guess this is the right time for them to get their roads fixed. And about time now for some business update. Emmanuel, I don't know whether or not you've come across this in any way, but they are demanding their roads are fixed before they vote.
Of course, like you said, this is the right time for them because you fail to get it this time, wait for another four years. You can trust politicians.
Anyway, so you're coming with some business. Yes, any updates?
Well, in business, you know, the IMF was supposed to review Ghana's third program, IMF bailout program, this month, at the end of this month.
Okay.
But yesterday we had a report from an email report coming from Washington, D.C., that it has now postponed it to October. That's the last quarter. Means that Ghana is going to be starved of some funds because they're expecting about over $160 million in the third tranche.
Interesting.
Of review, yeah.
Okay. All right. Emmanuel Abuajiri will be bringing us those details right after these messages. Stay with us.